Hello, my name is Hayley Flaherty and I play Miss Honey in Matilda.
It's absolutely fantastic to have you here with us this morning and congratulations on the nominations. How does it feel?
Thank you. It feels great because we came here knowing that we were in the long list of 16 and we just really hoped after the What's on Stage Awards that we would be nominated. So it's really good for us. We're really, really happy. Thank you.
Of course, I mean, the show's already had so many accolades and praises heaped upon it, but what does the Olivier Awards recognition specifically mean to you and the cast?
Well, I think for us, we've won so many Olivier's before with the original company, and it's amazing, but for the show to continue being nominated for something as prestigious as this is great for us. And I think it lets the public know that it's the actual show that's phenomenal, and we're just going to carry on making it better and better.
What do you think it is personally about the show that keeps it so much in people's imaginations and keeps it so beloved?
Well, growing up, it was my favourite Roald Dahl book. So I think at the heart of it, there's just this lovely story. Things that people can recognise in themselves, like the bullying. We have children, we have funny adults, we have sad bits, happy bits, amazing music, and really, really clever choreography. And I think in this time, so like people are worried about money and they're worried about like things going on in the world, it's just a really nice piece to come and see. And we have adults who think it's a children's show and they leave having like the best night at the theatre of their life, so we're really lucky. And I think the kids help us, the kids boost the adults, and it's just like a really happy place to work, which sounds really sad, but we're all really happy there, so it helps. And whenever you come to these awards, like for me, there's things I'm like, oh, I wish I'd seen that, or I haven't had a chance to see that yet. We're so lucky, I think, in the West End that there's something for everyone, whether it's straight acting or new plays, old plays, revivals. We're really lucky that we get the chance to put our foot in all these different doors. It's a great place to work.
And are there any other nominees you've especially got your fingers crossed for this year that you were especially pleased to see nominate?
I'm really pleased with Charlie and the Chocolate Factory, with it being another Roald Dahl show. And also Peter Darling, who's our choreographer, he's been nominated. Just really excited for everyone. I hope the nominees are really excited today, and good luck to everyone.
I guess, I mean, the obvious question on a day like today, what do you think defines London as, in some respects, the theatre capital of the world? What makes it such a unique place to perform?
Gosh, I think we have these old theatres, we have new theatres, we have, like we said before, straight plays, we have musicals, we have comedies, we have tiny little venues like the Comedy Stores, and I think we're kind of up for anything in London, I think, so people come here to see the variety of things that we can put on. I don't really know what it is, it's just like a big melting pot of all the different genres of theatre, and something for everyone. Maybe that's the secret, I don't know.
I guess my final question, just bringing it back to the show, I think obviously Miss Honey is a character that in many ways is the heart of Matilda. I think she's such a sweet and endearing character. Why do you think people respond so well to that character? Why do you think that she seems to represent so many things to so many people?
Well, it wasn't until I started to play the role myself that you realise she's sweet and lovely, but she's not weak. And she's had the terrible upbringing, she was bullied, and she's still managed to come out on top. She's still really frightened of the Trunchbull, but she sees this one little person, Matilda, who is a bit like a mirror image of herself, and she goes beyond the fears of the Trunchbull, and she just will do anything to make this little girl's life better. And I think she finds a little soulmate in Matilda, and I think people see, just like, she's a lovely character. I mean, it's lovely for me to play because you get to be really, really sweet with the kids, and then you get to be frightened of the Trunchbull, and then you get to tell this horrible story of what's happened to her, but still come out on top. So maybe she is the hero of the piece, but I think if it wasn't for Matilda and the kids, she'd be nothing. So I rely on them a lot.